During this demo, I'm going to show you how the Monkey Data Warehouse fabric actually works in practice and what the added value is for your historical layer. So let's start off by running this pipeline in the background. I'm going to explain it step by step in just a few minutes. There's a website, monkeydatawarehouse.com. You can visit it, you know, have some more details about all the features that I included, and also an architectural picture which explains a bit step by step how it works, and you can use it later on to discuss it. But first things first, let's head over to the lakehouse. For this demo, I did create a new folder called demo, which is now our new source. I did upload two files, a customer file and a people file. One is CSV, the other one is Parquet, so you can use both of them together. And both of them include an export timestamp, as you can see in here. And we're now going to process and add these new tables, so to say, to the data warehouse by just running this pipeline that I just showed you. But first things first, so what the pipeline is going to do, the first step is to convert these files into Delta tables. So these files will be picked up. These will be converted into Delta tables. And then based on the metadata from the Delta tables, it will fetch the column name, the table name, and the data type. And then using this metadata, it will generate all the historical objects for the data warehouse that it needs to process the files. So in this case, a table, a couple of views, and a store procedure for each file or object that it's being added to the data warehouse. And then as soon as that one has been completed, it will process the files, I think up to 12 in parallel, depending on your fabric capacity. You can, of course, process more files. But this is basically what it does for the data warehouse. And it just finished the converting the files. So if I now refresh this one, you can see that the customer file is converted into a Delta table, which you can actually just query and open up and see what's in it. And what the runbook did, it did add the file name and file date to the data set. And both of them are being added to the data warehouse and the historical layer later on. So let's head over to this one. It is now fetching the metadata. I'm going to let it run. Let's head over to the warehouse. The data warehouse holds a logging schema with a couple of views, which you can use. A pipeline trigger time, source name, object name, status, duration, insert, update, and deletes. So deletes will be recorded as soon as you configure it in the framework, but also if you export a source table as a full export. So just everything in there, dump it to Parquet and start processing it. And what it actually does, so the Monkey Data Warehouse will then function as sort of a black box or a flight recorder. So every data change, including deleted records, will be recorded inside your fabric warehouse. And I'm a data engineer and I love querying things with SQL. So what this does, it creates an historical table for each object or file that you upload and then process. So I'm going to head over to the pipeline. It did finish up generating all the objects and it's actually being completed for processing each file in parallel right now. So let's head over to the warehouse. And you can see in here that the new demo schema just popped up. So we have a customer and we have a people table. And let's see what's in here. Give it a few seconds. There it is. So it does hold a lot of things. But the most important things right now are the technical columns. So there's a hash key and hash div, but also file name, date. And then a start date and end date, is current, is latest, and is deleted. And which is actually really useful for your historical layer inside your Microsoft Fabric. That's it. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please let me know. Don't forget to go to the website and dive into more details about the Monkey Data Warehouse for Fabric. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.